بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم السلام علیکم اسٹوڈنٹ آر کلاسز ڈسٹرب ڈیو ٹو کووڈ ایک ود آؤٹ پراپر اکوپمنٹ اینڈ اٹ از ویری ڈیفیکلٹ ٹو گیو آن لائن لیکچر نو آئی سیٹل ڈاؤن سم نیسسری اکوپمنٹ اینڈ ریکارڈ یور فسٹ لیکچر ان ویڈیو فارم ان سم وے آئی ٹرائی ٹو ڈیفائن پریویس ڈیٹا here in video form, that is a derivative test for local extreme values. It is chapter number 14 and its edition is 11, which I have sent you through classroom, and its solution is also available here. First we define the first derivative test for local extreme values. If f of x y has a local maximum or minimum values at an interior point AB of its domain, and if first partial derivative exists, then the partial derivative of f with respect to x at point AB is equal to 0, and the partial derivative of f with respect to y at point AB is equal to 0. Now I try to define the critical point. It is same, its definition is same as we define for one variable. An interior point of the domain of a function f of xy, where the partial derivative of f with respect to x and the partial derivative of f with respect to y are 0, or one or both f of x, the partial derivative of f with respect to x and partial derivative of f with respect to y do not exist. That is, that point is called the critical point of the function, where these conditions must be must fulfill. Either the partial derivative of f with respect to x and with respect to y are 0, or one or both the partial derivative of f with respect to x and partial derivative of f with respect to y does not exist. These are the necessary conditions to satisfy our critical point. Now I try to define what is meant by the saddle point. In one variable, in your intermediate classes, you know this point as an point of inflection. Now we here in several variables, we name it the saddle point. A differentiable function f of xy has a saddle point at a critical point AB if every open disk centered at AB there are domain points xy where the function value is greater than the function value at AB, and the domain point xy where f of xy is less than f of AB. The corresponding point AB and the value of the function at AB is called the saddle point. Here I use the terminology open disk. Open disk means a body whose outer boundary is absent. Or we say in derivative function, we say that the differentiable function always its derivative exists in the open interval. In the same way, in several variables, we name it a open disk. Open disk means where the body has no defined boundary. Now, I move towards the second derivative test. Their notes, the notes on this topic, I have sent you before this in a PDF format. Now I define second derivative test. Suppose f of xy, its first and second order partial derivatives are continuous throughout a disk centered at AB, and the partial derivative of f with respect to x at AB and the partial derivative of f with respect to y at AB is equal to 0. Then the following characteristics must hold to identify either the function hold maxima, minima, saddle point, or the function shows no behavior. Following are the main characteristics. Number one, f has local maxima. F has local maxima at point AB if the second order partial derivative of f with respect to x is less than zero, and the product of second time partial derivative of f with respect to x and y minus the partial derivative of f with respect to x and y square is greater than zero at AB. If this condition hold, the second time partial derivative of f with respect to x is less than zero, and this value is greater than, this is called the determinant. If the value of the determinant, this value is called determinant. If the value of the determinant is greater than zero at this point, and the partial derivative of f with the second time partial derivative of f with respect to x is less than zero, then there hold local maxima at this point. Similarly, if the function f has local minima at AB, if the second time partial derivative of f with respect to x is greater than 0 and the discriminant value is greater than 0, then function hold local minima. If this condition hold, you must kept in mind these condition. When you apply these condition, then you find how in determining the value of a function at a point, either it is maxima or minima, you must understand, must hold these value in your mind. Number three, a function f has a saddle point. A function f has a saddle point at AB if the value of the determinant is less than zero at a point. This thing you must kept in your mind. Similarly, the part four, if the determinant value is equal to zero, so in this case we say test fails. We choose other way to find the behavior of f at AB. Other way mean we choose other technique. Let's say the first order derivative, first order derivative test, or some other ways in which you find the behavior of the function, either it is maxima or minima. Now, we move towards exercise in which that exercise is 14.7, and we use second derivative test. Either the first derivative test, is some way little bit difficult as compared to the second derivative test. It is easy to apply, and you easily understand the value of the function. Here I solve three types of problem: one for the maxima, one for the minima, and one for the saddle point. So here the heading is find local maxima, local minima, and the saddle point. And the technique that we used here, it is the second derivative test. So question number one is, given function is f of xy is equal to x square plus xy plus y square plus 3x minus 3y plus 4. Say this is equation number one. Now we want to find the critical point. For finding the critical point, the value of the critical point, we differentiate this function with partial differentiate this function with respect to x and with respect to y. So I write here, to find the critical point, partially differentiate equation number one with respect to x and y. In this way, after differentiation, we get fx is equal to 2x plus y plus 3, and fy is equal to x plus 2y minus 3, and I'm naming it alpha and beta. To find their values, substitute the partial derivative of f with respect to x is equal to 0, and the partial derivative of f with respect to y is equal to 0. We say by definition. In this way, when you substitute this is equal to 0, you get alpha is equal to 2x plus y plus 3 is equal to 0, and beta is equal to x plus 2y minus 3. Now, these two equations become the simultaneous equations. You solve these simultaneous equations for the values of x and y. When you solve these two equations simultaneously, you get x is equal to minus 3 and y is equal to 3. So the value of the critical point is in this way, that is equal to minus 3, 3. Again, partially differentiate. Now we have to find the local maxima, local minima, and the this function hold local maxima, local minima, or saddle point at this point. So for this, we have to differentiate alpha and beta again with respect to x and with respect to y. So I partially differentiate equation number alpha with respect to x. This is equal to the second time partial derivative of f with respect to x is equal to 2, and the second time partial derivative of f with respect to y is equal to 2, and the partial derivative of f first time with respect to x and then with respect to y is equal to 0. If you calculate f partial derivative of f with respect to y and then x, both are same. It is there is no difference between the partial derivative of f with respect to x and with respect to y, and the partial derivative of f with respect to y and with respect to x. In this way, when you find the partial derivative of fx with respect to y, you get that is equal to 1. And check their second time partial derivative at the critical point. You see here, the second time partial derivative of f with respect to x at minus 3, 3 is equal to 2. Similarly, the second time partial derivative of f with respect to y at this point is equal to 2. And the second time partial derivative of f with respect to x and y at this point is equal to 1. Now, we use test. Either we get maxima or minima or the saddle point at the given value. Now you check the discriminant f. At this point, we get 2 into 2 minus 1 is equal to 3, 3, and it is positive 3 and it is greater than 0. Before this, the value of f, the second time partial derivative of f with respect to x, here you see that is 2. At this point, it is greater than 0, it is a positive value. And here, the value of the discriminant, it is also greater than 0. When the discriminant value is greater than 0 and the second time partial derivative of f with respect to x is greater than 0, in this case, function holds minima. Function holds minima. So, function has local minima at minus 3, 3, and we want to find the value of the function at this point. Substitute this point in the given function. When we substitute the given the value of the critical point in the given function, we get minus 5. That is the minimum value that we obtained. Now, the next question is, and the next question related with the local maxima. Here is question number 3 from 14.7 exercise. The given function is f of xy is equal to 2xy minus 5x square minus 2y square plus 4x plus 4y minus 4. When we partially differentiate f with respect to x, we get 2y minus 10x plus 4. And when we partially differentiate f with respect to y, that is equal to 2x minus 4y plus 4. To find the extreme values, again we substitute their partial derivative equal to 0, and we get in this form minus 10x plus 2y plus 4 is equal to 0 and 2x minus 4y plus 4 is equal to 0. So solve these two equations, become solved by simultaneous equations. Solve the simultaneous equation and we have x is equal to 2 by 3 and y is equal to 4 by 3. So the value of the critical point xy is equal to 2 by 3, 4 by 3. Now we try to calculate the second time partial derivative of f with respect to x, second time partial derivative of f with respect to y, and the second time partial derivative of f with respect to x and y. Because we have to find the discriminant, and we also know the value of the partial derivative of f with respect to the second time partial derivative of f with respect to x. On the basis of these two values, we justify either the function is maximum or minimum. The second time partial derivative of f with respect to x is equal to minus 10 when you differentiate the above function. In the similar way, the second time partial derivative of f with respect to y is equal to minus 4, and the second time partial derivative of f with respect to xy is equal to 2. When you check this function at the value of critical point, it remains minus 10, minus 4 and 2. Now we find the value of the discriminant, that is equal to 36, which is greater than 0. Here the second time partial derivative of f with respect to x is minus 10, which is less than 0. Here the value of the discriminant is greater than 0, and the second time partial derivative of f with respect to x is less than 0. So in this way we know that hence the function has maxima at this point. These are the conditions for the maximum value. These are the conditions for the maximum value function, and its value is the value of the function at this point is f of 2 by 3 4 by 3 is equal to 0. Now the last example in which we see this question relate with the saddle point. Here the function is given. Again we find the partial derivative of f with respect to x and partial derivative of f with respect to y. Again we substitute, both are equal to 0. These become the simultaneous equations. We solve it for x and y. We get x is equal to minus 2 and y is equal to 1. So the value of the critical point is minus 2 and 1. Now we find the second time partial derivative of f with respect to x, the second time partial derivative of f with respect to y, and the second time partial derivative of f with respect to x and y. Here we find these values and check at the critical point. And then we find here the discriminant. Here you see that its value is negative 1. And we already know that these conditions only hold when saddle point exists. If the value of the discriminant is less than 0. If the value of the discriminant is less than 0 and the second time partial derivative of f with respect to is greater than 0, then we say that the function has saddle point. The function has saddle point. In the next video, we will move toward absolute extreme values. Absolute extreme values. Inshallah ta'ala, I shall see you in the next video. Okay, Allah Hafiz.